As you can see, I'm back outside. This is a full-time job. Somebody tell you it's not, they ain't doing it right. It's a full-time job right here, you know, taking care of these bullies, making sure everything is everything. Any kind of dog you got is a full-time job. But yeah, it's full-time. This ain't, you can't part-time this shit. If you part-time this shit, the dogs ain't getting the right care. So you're gonna have to put some stuff on hold. They go over there, looking crazy. And here he go, he wanna jump on folks. She just wanna sunbathe, he trying to fuck with her. She ain't trying to hear that. Yeah. I'm getting a lot of, different people starting a lot of different YouTube pages and Instagram pages. They doing their breeds and they got their different dogs and different whatnot that they got going on. I just like to say one thing. Props and shout outs to anybody that's even trying to get involved with this, because it's hard work, you know. It's hard work raising that man right there. It's hard work raising him. You know, it's hard work raising her. They all got to get their own special treatment and care. And, you know, you just got to make sure you up on your game before you start off in this thing, because it's a lot of variables. There's a lot of stuff to be considered. It's cost effective. You know what I'm saying? You spend a lot of money on the same stuff. You buy the same stuff twice sometimes. You know, shots, vet visits, immunizations, warmer, food, time. You know, these dogs got to go out and have walks, and you know, you got to socialize with them so they won't be disconnected from your family and whatnot. If you got kids, you got to make sure they're kid friendly. You know, it's just a lot that go into it. You know, I'm a beginner with this bully breed, but welcome to Purebred Bully Farms. You in the beginning stages. We just did our first breeding, and we gonna make sure that we follow everything to the letter. We kinda wanna set a standard, you know, of what this thing should be. We don't wanna be out here just breeding for the money. And I never tried to sell nobody a dog. Even when I was breeding pit bulls, I never tried to sell anybody anything. People called me about buying a dog from me. People ask me, do I have any puppies? People asking me. I don't never advertise nothing that's for sale or this, that, and the third. People come to me to get stuff. Since I've been having pit bulls, buying cars, whatever I've been doing, people come to me for what they want. I don't never say, hey, I'm selling this. I don't never post that I'm selling puppies. I never done it. You can go on any of my Instagram pages. You can go on any page I've ever had. You can go on any site I've ever had. I never tried to sell nobody nothing. People call me with interest in what I have. So that's always a good thing. You know, it's not good to push sales on people. And I screen the people who get my dogs. I screen the people who get my puppies. I don't just sell you a puppy because you got the money. I want to know where it's going to, what type of home environment it's going to have. You know, do you have a house or apartment? Because some of these dogs need a yard to run around in. Are you a busy person? If you're a busy person, don't get no bully. Because one thing I learned about this particular breed, they want all your time. They want to be in all your business. They don't want it to be a day where you don't have a minute for them. So you can't just lock these dogs up and just that's it. And they just locked up all day in a kennel or cage or whatever. You see, they got adequate room to move around, but they not in there right now. They out here, you know, walking about. You know, they out here walking about. They running around the yard. They playing. They socializing. I'm back here with them. I don't just let them out and just run back in the house and sit and watch TV. I'm out here with them, you know. Oh, and I got to use my disclaimer because they always trying to fight. Purebred Bully Farms does not condone the exploitation of animals of any kind. And we just frown down on that. We try to keep everything even keel. We don't like our dogs out here fighting. We don't have no food bowl aggressive dogs. We don't breed aggressive dogs at all. When it's time to be aggressive, these dogs know what to do. They born with that instinct. So you don't have to train and pinch and poke on them. They already ready, you know. And anybody who know me, they know that I'm a good dude. I don't like to really, I'm humble. You know what I'm saying? I'm thankful for everything I get. I'm thankful for everybody who follows, likes, subscribes, or anything to me. I don't really associate myself with a lot of people, so I don't be expecting 50,000 likes or nothing, because I don't, you know, I'm not out here like that. I'm not out here for what you like and for you to like me. I'm just out here just to spread the wealth of knowledge that I do have, that I have accumulated over these years, you know. I ain't get these gray hairs from nothing. But enough of this rambling on, you know. We got the breeding. Sosa and Medusa is going down. Get in line and get in line for your Jordans. He's still trying to mate with her. We're going to do one more AI just to make sure everything good. But he done got her a couple of times, so we should be sweet. But we're going to make sure. They just say, I done had both of them since they was 6-7 weeks old, so they like to play. We're going to keep it PG. I'm going to let y'all see all that.